Good morning. I'm Sergeant Browning, Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander, Student Liaison Officer at the New South Wales Police Academy. Goulburn and the surrounding area was originally a very important meeting place for various Aboriginal mobs and clans. Because of its locality, it was a very central point to bring the mobs together. Goulburn was not inhabited by just one group of people, it had many groups. Sacred sites include Rocky Hill, Marsden Weir, Lansdowne Estate, Kenwell and Goulburn Railway Station. Goulburn has always been a place of bringing people together, and this tradition is being carried on today. New South Wales Police Academy is honoured that the land they occupy is the traditional lands of the Mulwarri, Talo, Burra Burra, Wurrungdilly, Wiradjuri, Gundagara, Darug, Thurl, Lachlan, Pajong, Paramagoo, Cockmore and Ngunnawal people. We respectfully acknowledge the region's Aboriginal heritage, people and elders both past and present and future.
The New South Wales Police Force banner is carried by Senior Sergeant Brooke Russell, Protocol and Awards Unit. The escorts to the banner are Senior Constables Paul Doyen, Protocol and Awards Unit, and Vincenzo Pizzullo, Police Transport Command. The banner was presented to the New South Wales Police Force at the National Police Remembrance Day Ceremony in Sydney on the 29th of September 2006 by the Governor of New South Wales, Her Excellency Professor Mari Bashir, in her capacity at the time as Administrator to the Government of the Commonwealth of Australia. The New South Wales Police Force banner is held in great esteem as it represents the proud history and traditions of a force which has served the Crown, Government and people of New South Wales since 1862. Thank you. Please be seated. The parade commander will now invite His Excellency to inspect the parade. Thank you. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the New South Wales Police Academy for the Attestation Parade for members of Class 328 of the Constable Education Program. Your Excellency and Deputy Premier, your attendance at today's parade signifies your strong interest and support for the New South Wales Police Force. Commissioner, this assembly of policing students, soon to become frontline police officers, will provide tangible support to the men and women already serving our community at operational policing commands. Ladies and gentlemen, will you please stand as the Senior Police Chaplain, the Reverend Owen Davies, blesses the parade.
Loving God, before whom all hearts are open and no secrets are hidden, and who forgives our faults as we forgive others. During this season of transition from the cold of winter to the warmth of spring, we seek your blessing on Class 328 through a revelation of your love and new life in the face of every moment of their service, through all the joys and challenges ahead. And now, as the moment for which these students have worked and of which they have dreamed is here, for which they have prepared in body, mind and spirit, bless them during their probationary period of further study and on-the-job training. Please reinforce in them the knowledge and skills and values demonstrated through their time at the Academy. Bless them with wise and skillful mentors and colleagues. Bless all who celebrate this attestation parade, especially the families and friends. Bless them with your amazing grace in their homes. We thank you for their patient, generous and loving support that has brought Class 328 this far. Grant that there may never be a shortage of women and men like Class 328, who strive for the best with moral courage and compassion, strength and sensitivity, resourcefulness and resilience to serve the people of New South Wales in the cause of law and order, justice and the common good. We pray for your blessing on the Governor and Government of New South Wales, the Minister for Police, the Commissioner, the officers and all who serve with the New South Wales Police Force. Bless the faculty of Charles Sturt University, the Commander and staff of the Academy. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you, watch over and protect you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen.
The parade commander will now prepare the students for their attestation. I now invite Commissioner Andrew Scipione to attest the members of Class 328.
Good morning, Class 328. For those of you that are taking the oath of office, substituting your own several names for mine, repeat this solemn oath of office. I, Andrew Philip Scipione, do swear that I will well and truly serve our Sovereign Lady the Queen as a police officer, without favour or affection, malice or ill will, until I am legally discharged. That I will cause Her Majesty's peace to be kept and preserved. And that I will prevent, to the best of my power, all offences against that peace. And that while I continue to be a police officer, I will, to the best of my skill and knowledge, discharge all of my duties faithfully, according to law. So help me God. To those that are taking the affirmation, substituting your own several names for mine, repeat this solemn affirmation of office. I, Andrew Philip Scipione, do solemnly, sincerely, and truly declare and affirm that I will well and truly serve our Sovereign Lady the Queen as a police officer, without favour or affection, malice or ill will, until I am legally discharged. That I will cause Her Majesty's peace to be kept and preserved, and that I will prevent, to the best of my power, all offences against that peace. And that while I continue to be a police officer, I will, to the best of my skill and knowledge, discharge all of my duties faithfully, according to law. Congratulations.
Thank you, Commissioner. Parade Commander will now direct the newly attested probationary constables to remove their student cap bands. This will reveal their badge of office and the checkered cap band, being an internationally recognised symbol of policing. Please withhold your applause until the probationary constables have returned to the attention position. I invite your host officer, Chief Superintendent Tony Crandell, to welcome you here today.
Governor of New South Wales, His Excellency the Honourable David Hurley, AC, DSC, retired. Mrs. Linda Hurley, Deputy Premier of New South Wales and Minister for Justice and Police, Troy Grant. Commissioner of Police, Andrew Scipione, AO, APM. Deputy Commissioner Corporate Services, David Hudson, APM. Acting Deputy Commissioner Field Operations, Carlene York, APM. Deputy Commissioner Specialist Operations, Catherine Byrne, APM. Commander, Education and Training Command, Acting Assistant Commissioner Julie Middlemiss. Retiring Officer, Detective Superintendent Stuart Wilkins, APM. Professor Mary Kelly, Deputy Vice Chancellor, Charles Sturt University. The Honourable Katrina Hodgkinson, MP, Parliamentary Secretary for Southern New South Wales. Mr. Tony Taylor, CEO, Police Bank. Distinguished guests, and most importantly, welcome to the family and friends of students in Class 328. On behalf of the New South Wales Police Force and Charles Sturt University, welcome to this morning's attestation parade. It was not long ago, members of Class 328 arrived at the Goulburn Police Academy. They were a diverse group with a common goal and a common bond. That is to become police officers, to make a difference to their communities. They are people who stand before you today ready, ready to take on the challenge of policing in the greatest police force in the greatest state. Proud families and friends gathered here today, your support in every case over many months with many absences must be acknowledged, because today is as much about the strength of your support as it is of individual achievements by every one of the police officers standing in front of you. I'm also sincerely grateful for the dedicated teachers and support staff of both the New South Wales Police Force and Charles Sturt University. The transition from student to police officer is an evolution that requires persistence from everyone involved. I think you will all agree that remarkable outcomes, and there are 208 here today, often require help from remarkable people, which accurately describes our teachers, administration and support staff at the New South Wales Police Academy. I'm so very proud of our newest probationary constables. To each of you, congratulations and well done. You will remember this day for the rest of your lives because you are at the start of a fantastic journey with rich rewards at every turn. The rewards I speak of include challenges of preventing and reducing crime, creating confidence among marginalised communities, and making communities safe and secure in an environment of dramatic change. Over the next 12 months, these challenges you will face as an operative on the front line of operational policing, again with support from your families, from your new brother and sister officers, and from your commanders. They will contribute to the creation of you as a unique person who will become the most competent police officer the New South Wales Police Force on behalf of the New South Wales Government can produce. Within this environment, you will rise to the challenge by doing well the very jobs many can only dream of. Class 328, besides wishing I was standing beside you, it gives me great pleasure to acknowledge that you are no longer students or recruits. You are probationary constables within the New South Wales Police Force. You are the future of the New South Wales Police Force. You have earned the right to exercise powers that will keep communities safe across this state. I wish you every success in your personal and professional lives, and close by saying simply that today belongs to you. It is now my great honour to invite His Excellency General, the Honourable David Hurley, AC, DSC retired, Governor of New South Wales, to address the parade.
Ladies and gentlemen, despite the weather, a very warm welcome, I think, here today to a very important occasion in the life of the young people, not so young, I see one or two, on parade here today, and their families and supporters who have gathered here for, as we have heard, a very special occasion. I begin, of course, by acknowledging the traditional owners of the land we're gathered here today and pay my respects to the elders past and present, and also to our distinguished guests that are with us. It is one of the greatest moments of these parades when you take off that blue ribbon and reveal the blue and white check band around your hat. It's heartwarming, but it's deeply symbolic because it says, from now you are different. You now have the education and training behind you. But from that first day in the coming week, when you step out into the street, in the public, in that uniform, people will look at you differently. You represent so much to the communities, to the people of New South Wales. You represent peace and order. You represent security as they sleep at night, as they go about their work. You represent all that we have, in one sense, that prevents us from descending into chaos in communities. That is a heavy responsibility. And as you took that oath today, you are assuming that responsibility fair and square. But I have every confidence, knowing how this training is conducted at this academy, that you are extremely well equipped to undertake those responsibilities. And more than that, you are the caliber of person who will fulfill those responsibilities to the last dot. Now, you will know from your history lessons here, perhaps those in the audience don't, that the police force originated by selecting the best behaved convicts in New South Wales. Thankfully, we've moved on from there. And what we have is a high quality force, high tech force, but the backbone in any organisation is its people. So for all the parents, friends and supporters here today, thank you for agreeing with the decisions that these young people have taken and being here, not only today, but being with them throughout the training activities and the educational activities. It's a big ask to essentially self-fund yourself into our police force. It's an enormous sacrifice. And I commend you all, those on parade and those here witnessing today, for what you've done. To the staff and the staff at the academy and the staff from CSU, thank you for all the hard work that goes into this outcome we see on parade today. Again, you have done a masterful job, and we continue to have a lot of confidence in the way this course is managed. I look forward to seeing you on the streets. Last week, Linda and I were in Tibooburra, in northwest New South Wales. You can't go much further and you get into those foreign states. A one-man police town. Glen Lazarby up there, population of 100-odd people. He is the only representative of the New South Wales Police in that location and doing a fantastic job. Well loved by the community, integrated into the community, in fact, a leader of the community. There is a fine example for where your careers should take you. If you don't know him, email him, he'll wonder what's happened, but find out the secrets to doing what he is doing, the community well behind you, walking side by side with you. Congratulations, well done today. Great privilege for Linda and I to be here with you today to share this occasion. Well done.
Thank you, Your Excellency. I now invite the Honourable Troy Grant, MP, Deputy Premier, Minister for Justice and Police, Minister for Racing, and Minister for the Arts to address the parade.
Good morning, everybody. If I could also acknowledge the custodians of this land, the traditional custodians and their ancestors. To His Excellency the Honourable David Hurley, AC, DSC, retired, our Governor of New South Wales, and Mrs. Hurley, can I thank you, Your Excellency, for your unwavering support of all the men and women, sworn and unsworn, in our New South Wales Police Force, and your dedication to them is sincerely appreciated. Commissioner Andrew Scipione, APM, Deputy Commissioners Byrne, APM, Deputy Commissioner Hudson, APM, and Acting Deputy Commissioner York, APM. Thank you for your stewardship of the organisation, and to all men and women sworn and unsworn from the New South Wales Police Force who attend these attestation parades as I do, and each time receive a remarkable reminder of the pride and privilege that we all feel having worn that uniform or currently wearing that uniform. We understand very well the emotions that you're feeling today. This is an incredibly special day. You have now just entered the greatest police force in the world, I believe. The one with the proudest of traditions. One with the highest levels of responsibilities. As your minister, I understand clearly what my role is. Having stood exactly where you were standing some 27 years ago and walking the streets you're about to walk on for some 22 years myself, I understand very clearly the challenges that you will face. You will see the very best in humanity. You'll also see the very worst. You will be challenged day in and day out. Your innocence will be tested. So will your courage and your resilience. But the training you have been provided as you go on from this day to protect and serve the communities of where you've been posted will stand you in good stead. As will the support and guidance of your supervisors and your teammates in the New South Wales Police Force. Lean on them, rely on them to guide you through some of the difficult days that you face. But always do it remembering that oath of office that you took. There's nothing more important than that oath of office that you just took. It is your guiding principle and should remain with you every day that you serve. We ask a lot of our police officers, and we continue to ask a lot of you. The challenges you face, they're very, very local to the communities in which you serve. But they are increasing day by day, and they are becoming global challenges as well. We rely on you, we trust you, and we appreciate you, particularly for choosing a vocation and a career. This is not just a job. It is a calling to serve others before you serve yourself. We thank you for making this decision. We trust that you go well, and we'll do the New South Wales Police Force the enormous pride that it deserves. On behalf of the Premier Mike Baird, New South Wales Government, as your Minister, I give you this commitment. You continue to look after the people of New South Wales, and we'll always continue to look after you. Keep safe, look after each other, and God bless.
Thank you, Deputy Premier. I now invite Commissioner Andrew Scipione, AO, APM, to address the parade.
Thank you. His Excellency the Honourable David Hurley, AC, DSC, retired, and Mrs. Lynn Hurley. Your Excellency, thank you again for putting on that blue uniform. We truly are encouraged when we see somebody of your status and standing within community proudly wearing the New South Wales Police uniform, and it's always a pleasure to have you here. The Honourable Troy Grant MP, Deputy Premier, Minister for Justice and Police. The Honourable Katrina Hodgkinson MP, Parliamentary Secretary for Southern New South Wales. Professor Mary Kelly, the Deputy Vice Chancellor, Charles Sturt University. Distinguished guests, my colleagues in policing, former and serving, family members, friends, most importantly, members of Class 328. Well, good morning, everyone, and welcome to our second attestation for 2016. I too would like to acknowledge the traditional owners of the lands on which we meet here today and pay my respect to their elders, both past and present. Well, let me begin by congratulating our newest constables who are graduating today. 208 men and women with backgrounds as diverse as the communities that you're going out there to serve. My policing colleagues and I know very well the sense of pride and satisfaction that each of you must be feeling right now. I want you to think about that feeling. I want you to remember it, to enjoy it, because you've earned it. You've proven yourself physically, mentally, and academically fit for one of the most demanding jobs that there is. And the reason I ask each of you to stop and remember your sense of pride and satisfaction is because it's important that you never, ever lose it. Professional policing doesn't just happen because of the training that you've received or the equipment that you're going to carry or the uniform that you're wearing right now. It requires pride. It requires passion and commitment. Always remember why you wanted to become a police officer, why you wanted to be standing right where you're standing today. Always remember the pride you're feeling right now. And let those feelings carry and serve you throughout your careers. Class 328 today, for you, today is a very memorable day. Memorable for the professional and personal milestones that you've achieved. More memorable still for the journey that you now begin. The oath of office that you've just taken will require you to do things that you've never ever done before. It will connect you with people whose lives would never have intersected with your own had you chosen a different profession. It will challenge some deeply held personal beliefs. And above all else, it will reveal the full range of human behaviour. You know, many people live their lives largely insulated from the darker side of human behaviour. Let me assure you, from today forward, you will not. Yes, there's going to be days of great joy and pride and personal triumph. But there will also be days where you'll come face to face with the very worst that people can do to each other. And as a police officer, you won't be an observer. You won't be watching from the sidelines. Your oath of office means that you'll be taking part. Whether on duty or off duty, your oath of office carries with it obligations to uphold the law and act with integrity. The community of New South Wales has placed great trust in you, and from today you have the privilege of serving the community as police officers. With that privilege goes responsibility, and there is no higher responsibility than that of service to your community. I want to pause on one word, integrity. Expect to hear that word again and again. Because as a police officer, the community has entrusted you with powers that are not given to others. The power to carry arms, to use coercive force, to enter and search premises, to deprive people of their liberty, and to require them to actually defend themselves before the courts. Because of this, integrity is what the community expects of us as police, and it's what I expect of you as your police commissioner, nothing less. And that's whilst you're on duty and whilst you're off duty. Integrity must underpin everything that you do as police officers. And let there be no doubt, breaking the law is entirely incompatible with enforcing the law. If you lose my confidence, you will lose your career. Having sounded that note of warning, let me balance it. Let me balance it by saying that if you are honest, if you apply yourself, and you act to the best of your ability, then you will be glad of your decision to become a police officer. You will forge lifelong friendships. You'll interact with people from all walks of life. You'll have the opportunity to further your education and undertake cutting-edge specialist work. But most importantly, you'll have made a meaningful difference to people's lives. I'm going to be the first to acknowledge that you've made a brave decision in choosing to become a police officer. It's not a job for just anyone. It's not a job that just anyone can do. Your life will be changed from this point on. You'll be under constant scrutiny from me, from your colleagues, and from the public. You've worked hard to get here, but some of the hardest work lies ahead of you. But ask any officer who's had the honour of marching off this parade ground after a lifetime of service, if you could have your time again, would you choose another career? And I guarantee you that their answer would be no. And on that note, I'd like to turn to the contributions of one such officer whose career epitomises the highest ideals of policing and who formally leads our ranks today. He is Detective Superintendent Stuart Wilkins, APM, who marches off today with over 36 years of service to the New South Wales Police Force and, more importantly, to the community of New South Wales, most recently as the commander of the Tweed Byron Local Area Command. On behalf of the New South Wales Police Force, Stuart, and the community of New South Wales, I want to express my thanks and appreciation for your hard work, your loyalty, and your commitment. Your values and commitment embody what it means to be a police officer. It's what it means to be part of the force. You are a role model for each and every member of this graduating class, and To you, mate, well done, and my very best wishes for your retirement. And so, to the many family members and friends here today, I thank you. I thank you all for supporting our newest officers in getting to this day. I know that it wasn't achieved without sacrifice, moving away from family, from your friends, from loved ones, foregoing an income for the best part of the year. If it wasn't for the support of your families and over many months now, the men and women that we see here today would not be standing there. So to you, Class 328, to you, our soon-to-be serving officers, let me again encourage you, please enjoy and celebrate this day. This is your day, as has already been mentioned. I know that you've worked extraordinarily hard to get here. You've made enormous sacrifices to get here. And to each and every one of you, I want to congratulate you. Congratulations to all of you. I look forward to seeing you wearing your uniforms with pride when you're out on the street and I'm out there with you. Class 328, some people live their entire lives wondering whether they've made a difference in the world. Let me assure you, you won't have that problem. I welcome each of you to the profession of policing. Enjoy this day. It is an absolute pleasure to be here to have attested you and go forward safely. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Commissioner. The parade commander will now prepare the parade for the march past and the advance in review order. Ladies and gentlemen, the banner party will march past at the centre of the parade. As the banner passes your immediate front, please stand and uniformed personnel are to salute. Once the banner has passed you, please return to your seat. Thank you. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, the parade will now advance in review order. Please stand. All uniformed personnel are to salute for the royal salute. Thank you, please be seated. We would like to acknowledge the probationary constables on parade who have achieved levels of excellence during the course of their studies here at the Academy. The details of all the awards are contained in your attestation booklets. The following officers were presented with their awards at their formal dinner on Wednesday night. The recipients of the Robert Brotherson Award for Outstanding Academic Performance are Probationary Constables Elizabeth Carr and Beth Haig. The recipients of the Stephen Rosa Memorial Award for Outstanding Performance in the Physical Training Program are Probationary Constables Sinead Linton and Matthew Valente. The recipient of the Juan Carlos Hernandez Memorial Shield for the highest proficiency in firearms training is Probationary Constable Matthew Bull. The recipient of the Police Practical Award is Probationary Constable Benjamin Duncan. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, would you please stand for the Australian National Anthem? The Australian National Anthem will be sung by New South Wales Police Band vocalist Belinda Parsons. You are invited to join the members of Class 328 in singing the first verse of Advance Australia Fair. All uniformed personnel will salute on the command, present arms.
Golden soil and wealth for toil.
It is customary for retiring officers of the New South Wales Police Force with long and distinguished service to be marched off at attestation parades. Today's parade will acknowledge the retirement of Detective Superintendent Stuart Wilkins, APM. Details of Superintendent Wilkinson's years of service and achievements are located in the attestation parade booklets. Detective Superintendent Stuart Wilkins, APM, joined the New South Wales Police Force on the 17th of June 1980 as a trainee and attested on the 6th of April 1981. Superintendent Wilkins served the New South Wales Police Force with distinction for over 36 years. Superintendent Wilkins is invited to take up a position behind the banner party. The banner party and support units will now march off the parade ground. Prior to this, there will be a musical salute to the banner. During this salute, all uniformed personnel are to salute on the command of present arms. Please quit your salute when the banner party shoulders arms. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand. Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing as the banner party and support units are marched off the parade ground. Commander will now hand the parade back to the parade sergeant, who will dismiss the class. When the class is dismissed, you are all invited to celebrate with them on the parade ground. Congratulations, Class 328. We welcome you all to the New South Wales Police Force. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you.